And the new kid on the block, Dior Homme 2020. What do I think about it? Let's get into it. Gotta tell you, I dig the new packaging. Soon as I saw it in Macy's, I was like, wow, is that actually a new fragrance? But you guys know I love Dior Homme, so I could not wait. When they said new, I was excited. Didn't know anything about the note breakdown, couldn't see anything, sprayed it on my hand, and I was like, where is my fragrance? Where is my iris? What in the world were they thinking? Shout out to the CIA. What's going on, you modern sexy savages? I know you guys have missed me. I've been out sick for a long time, but I had to get back into it on this one. Guys, if you've been watching my channel for any length of time, you know I love the fragrance Dior Homme. There's something about chicken in that fragrance. But in 2020, Dior decided to drop a completely reformulated version of this fragrance. What do I think about it? Let's get into it. Shout out to the CIA. Guys, if you want to become part of the movement, do me a favor, join us on Patreon for exclusive video and live stream content that will only be visible there. Details down in the description. First of all, guys, here is the original Dior Homme. What made this fragrance fantastic, what made the entire fragrance line fantastic, was the note of iris. Just like in Dior Homme Sport back in 2017, they removed the iris from a sport fragrance, which I never thought belonged there in the first place. I always said it's kind of like playing basketball in church shoes, and they put in blood orange. I actually like the new Dior Homme Sport more than the original, but the original Dior Homme, I love this fragrance. I've often called it a masterpiece and an underrated fragrance. In 2020, they decided to remove the iris note and give us this more wood-based take on the fragrance. I'm going to tell you right off the bat, this fragrance is completely different than this one. I want to take you back to the 80s and the cola wars. There was Coca-Cola going to Pepsi, Pepsi and Coke, the cola wars, back and forth, back and forth. Then somebody in Coca-Cola had the bright idea of changing the original formula of Coke to make it sweeter. And what they did right there kicked off all kinds of problems. Coke came in so many different variations. They decided to try to make Coke sweeter to compete with Pepsi. Huge mistake. When people drank Coca-Cola, they liked the bite. What they found out is the original Coke was better, even though people liked sweeter initially. This one right here is like new Coke. You'll notice new Coke is nowhere on the market. Go back and look through the 80s and 90s and you'll see new Coke, new old Coke, classic Coke. This Coke. We had 10, 20 different versions of Coke on the market at one given time to only go back to say the original was where it's at. And for me, I'm gonna tell you, that's how I feel about this new fragrance. The original is where it's at. Now, for those of you who like the original, don't fear. This has not been discontinued. It is still on the market. It is just called Dior Homme Original. Now on the upside, there are a lot of guys who could not rock and wear the original because of the powdery note, because of the powderiness of the iris in the original. In that case, you actually might want to actually try this one out. Let me get into the C3PO system. Compliment factor, average. Now an above average compliment getter, people say you smell nice because you smell better than nothing. Performance, a solid 4 to 6 hours. Projection, 2 to 3 feet. CIs, 2 to 3 feet. An average performing fragrance. A style personnel I can see pulling this off, definitely gonna be much more that all-American kind of thing. I can see Don Draper or Ghost from Power wearing this. This is an inoffensive office-based fragrance. And the occasion I can see you wearing it, it's actually signature scent worthy. You can wear this all year round, not offend anybody, smell good. It does have a masculine take on it because of the woods and the kind of leaning towards the vetiver. And for me, I almost picked up some patchouli-like notes in the dry down. So I will tell you, the dry down is better than the opening. This is not a horrible fragrance, but it's nothing groundbreaking. It's nothing new. In my opinion, the original still takes the cake. But like always, hit us up in the comment section, let us know. Have you tried the new Dior Homme 2020? Did you like it? If so, cool. If not, cool. But keep it cool, keep it classy. God, what were you thinking? If you like this video, share it out to somebody that you think can use the information. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Till the next time. Talk at you later. Godfather, back. Hey guys, whether look, style, or life, whether personal or professional, you can level up and be your personal best each and every day. If you're interested in any of that, do us both a favor. Follow the link in the description and book your one-on-one session with me. Details down in the description. Peace.